Hey and welcome to Ahrefs monthly product updates. We have three tool updates, one cross-tool update, and two general updates to share today. Let's start with Site Explorer. We've added the best links filter to overview 2.0. Using the filter here affects all backlink related counts and historical charts. This lets you filter out link noise from all widgets. For example, here, we're looking at the referring domains graph for a few competing pages on wireless earphones. And if we hit the best links filter and select show best links only, it affects the graph like so. With the filter applied, these two results have even swapped places towards the end of 2023. This helps paint an even clearer picture of the performance over time when it comes to so-called good links. Remember that you can always configure your own custom settings here. Moving on. All Lite plan users, both legacy and new, can now access the site structure report for domain and subdomain level metrics. Site structure shows you the structure of a website in a tree format, along with metrics for each path level, without having to run a crawl. This helps you understand different sections of a website and how they contribute to its SEO. We've also depreciated a bunch of legacy backlink reports. This includes backlinks, broken backlinks, referring domains, anchors, internal backlinks, Best Buy links, Best Buy links growth, linked domains, and outgoing anchors. All reports already have a replacement in Site Explorer 2.0. Moving on to our cross-tool update. We've made two improvements to our SERP overview widget in Site Explorer, Keywords Explorer, and Rank Tracker. Firstly, we've added a new AI feature that identifies keyword search intent. Instead of categorizing search intent into traditional models like informational, navigational, or transactional, this classification is more granular and tells you in simple terms what people searching for the keyword might want to find. This gives you multiple paths or content angles that you can use to rank. For example, if you enter best microwave in Keywords Explorer and click on Identify Intents, we can see that the people searching for this keyword could be looking for product reviews and recommendations of the best performing microwave ovens or information on the most reliable microwave brands. Moving on. In our SERP overview widgets, we now show a new SERP feature, discussions and forums. We also take rankings in this feature into account when calculating organic traffic. Traffic is distributed equally between all URLs in this feature. Moving on to Rank Tracker. In the GSE keywords report, you can now filter by clicks, impressions, CTR, and position. We've also added a URLs column, which shows you the number of pages ranking for a keyword. Just click on a number to open a nested table and see all URLs. Moving on to Site Audit. Site Audit now reports problems with mobile usability on your site. The five issues we report on are: if a viewport is not set, if content is not sized correctly, if font size is too small, if tab targets are too small or too close together, and if a document uses plugins. You need to connect to PageSpeed Insights API, set the mobile user agent in your crawl settings, and run a new crawl for these issues to trigger. Moving on to our general updates. First up, you can now enable two-factor authentication, or 2FA, in Account Settings, My Account. This lets you improve account security with time-based passwords via mobile apps like Google Authenticator. If you're a workspace owner or admin, you can also make 2FA mandatory for all workspace members, from Account Settings, Members. Note that 2FA is tied to an account rather than a workspace. So if you're a member of multiple workspaces and one requires 2FA, you'll need to perform 2FA every time you sign in. Moving on to our last update. We've added a new API V3 endpoint for our anchors report in Site Explorer, so you can now fetch anchor texts at scale. As always, you can use the API button in the report to generate sample requests, and I'll leave a link to the API docs in the description below. And that's all for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our canny. See you in the next update and have a great day.